It'll take more than your obnoxious grit to get through. Yes, yes, you're immortal. Without the fear of death, you will never reach your full potential. Death is merely an inconvenience for you, not a limitation. We train, we fight, to push our limits. But what are yours, when you have nothing to lose? Pray they don't capture you.
This church was a monument to him. What a bulwark, chosen of Baldwin. People clamored in adoration. They sought to be anointed, as he was, by self-proclaimed gods. Usurpers who touted him like a trophy, inspiring entire generations into fervent devotion. In return, they promised immortality. Then you walk among the fools and the ghosts of Alduin. I watched as the bulwark's mind and body slowly decayed. But he never lost his sense of purpose, despite any who prayed here, having long since perished. And now you, who have silenced his thunder, this storm that once heralded judgment, now who shall deem whether one is worth becoming immortal or not? Perhaps I shall take upon his mantle. Why have you come to disturb the dead? Why have you come to disturb the dead? Leave this place and honor her memory. Whether you find her or not, no one is truly alive here. Empty, save for the memory of my parents. Nothing to bury. Time and their arrogance made certain of that. But their consciousness endures. A story for another time, perhaps. Follow me. Beyond these gates, you'll see Tir Ciorai. Within its walls is the dreaded source of immortality. Look upon the citadel, and consider your next move carefully.
Stragglers are being hunted. If any return to their homelands, it'll only be a handful.
Another expedition, marred by tragedy, remembered only by the mothers whose sons and daughters have fallen. The king will continue to celebrate the dead as heroes of the realm.
Their heroes accomplished little more than setting foot into Cyrodiil. How the standard has fallen. Their cadavers will be of more use as fertilizer.
They don't know any better. A child is not to blame for the environment in which they are raised. King Vowles must die.
He's not far off. Give it 10-20 years, he'll be a wretched pile of shivering bones by then.
No. Too many will suffer for his ambitions. Sorrow resonates through the kingdoms. I can feel it in the air, a fermenting thirst for revenge. But I will assuage their pain. No longer will a mother suffer the loss of a child. When all are immortal under the sun, I will be queen.
Well, well, maybe there's redemption for you yet. While you wish to go to Kaer Shorai while already an immortal confounds me. But I don't care much either way. Just know that if you attempt to take the source, I will cut you down without hesitation.
The sewers lead back to Sanctuary, and the head towards Kaer Shorai. Death needn't be so loathed, for you will be reunited with the loved ones you lost. But my soul has perished long ago, and I have not but dust to commune with my family. My choice to die was taken from me.
Venture no further. Will you still have that choice? If you won't heed my words...
Once my home, now a derelict tomb. May the remnants of my world convince you otherwise.